To continue my series on overpowered pets in WoW's history, today I'll go over the Death Adder Hatchling, and why it was a tier 0 pet back in Myst. The Death Adder Hatchling was added with the Timeless Isle as a drop from the rare pythons on the island. He also had multiple breeds available to him, but the only one that mattered was the SS breed. Now, I make these videos with the intention that whoever is watching them doesn't know anything about pet battles, so let me explain what SS breed means real quick, because I'm going to be mentioning it a lot more in this video. Pets have a breed which basically just means which stat they've been given extra stats to. So SS just means the pet was given all of its bonus stats in speed, since S stands for speed, so speed. And its power and health, the other two stats, are just mediocre in comparison. So when I talk about the Death Adder Hatchling being OP, I only mean the SS breed, or the fast one. Now, why was he overpowered? Well, because of a combination of skills he was given. First off, the new ability made just for him called Blinding Poison, which in its first form had a 3-turn cooldown and when used would reduce the hit chance of the opponent's pet by 100% for one round. So basically, they would just miss you on their next attack. Pretty straightforward ability. Now this is where the speedy Death Adder comes into play. You see, the poison will stay up for one turn, but if you go first in the turn and use it, the opponent's pet will miss the turn you use it on, plus the very next turn after as well, essentially giving you two turns of not being attacked instead of one, but only if you're faster than your opponent. And the Death Adder has a speed of 341 with its speedy breed, which is pretty fast for an SS breed. To put that into perspective, the average speed of another SS breed pet is 325. The average speed of a non-speedy pet is 260. So 325 is usually more than fast enough to outspeed a normal 260 pet. But 341 is even faster than fast pets. So the only meta pets that could actually outspeed a Death Adder Hatchling were rabbits, who had 357 speed with their SS versions, and flying type pets, because their racial gave them a 50% speed boost while above 50% health. And with Blinding Poison only having a 3-turn cooldown, if you were faster than your opponent, they only had 2 turns to hit you before it came back up to stop them for 2 more turns. So you were essentially missing half of your abilities against a Death Adder if you were slower. But that's not all. Death Adders also had an ability called Puncture Wound, which, also on a 3-turn cooldown just like Blinding Poison, did the same damage as a basic attack, but could do double damage if the target was poisoned. And wouldn't you know it, Blinding Poison counted the target as poisoned. Well, and blinded. It's the only ability in game that counts as two status effects in one, but the blinded part never matters. It's the poisoned one that is good, as not only could you make it so your opponent missed 2 turns and then only had 2 turns to counterplay, but he could also hit really damn hard in the process with double attacks. So the most common strategy used against a Death Adder was to simply swap out after getting Blinding Poison, so they couldn't puncture wound you for double damage. But Death Adders also have an ability called Poison Fang as their basic attack, which does half the damage of a basic attack up front and applies a 5-round dot, which also counts the target as poisoned. So even if you try to escape the Blinding Poison, you just get a Poison Fang poisoned instead and still get a double hit on the next turn. Of course, you could then swap out again to avoid the double damage puncture wound, but at this point you've swapped out 2 times and lost 3 turns already while taking damage the whole time, so you still come out at a loss. Plus, the Blinding Poison would be off cooldown at this point and the whole cycle would just start again. So the standard rotation for Death Adders was to start off with Blinding Poison, then use Poison Fang in case they swapped out, and then Puncture Wound. And the Blinding Poison would be up again and you could just repeat. The combo was so powerful that unless you just had a direct counter to Death Adders on your team, you were going to lose. The Death Adder just did too much damage while taking very little in return. And with its high speed, there was a very low chance you could deal with it unless you just happened to be running a flying type pet or a rabbit. Which, to be fair, rabbits were also really good at this time as well, and countered undead pets, so there was a good chance you'd run into a few or have one on your team. So it wasn't all bad, but then again, they could just not use their Death Adder Hatchling against your rabbit and win that way. Plus, the Death Adder Hatchling did extra damage to rabbits anyway, so it wasn't really a direct counter. Just more of a, you wouldn't be missing all the times if you had a rabbit. So, what was changed about the Death Adder? The Death Adder Hatchling was way too good not to be touched with the Nerf Bat. And well, its changes were pretty minor, but completely changed its meta dominance. You see, in Warlords, Blizzard just simply increased the cooldown on both Blinding Poison and Puncture Wound. Now Blinding Poison has a 4-turn cooldown instead of 3, and Puncture Wound has a 4-turn cooldown instead of 3. With a 1-turn cooldown nerf to both skills, pets would only now be missing for 2 turns, but then get 3 turns to actually do stuff instead of only 2. So it was no longer 2 on, 2 off, and was now 3 on and only 2 off. Having one more turn every cycle to actually counterplay was pretty helpful and not as overpowered. Also, with a one more turn cooldown on Puncture Wound, it just straight up lowered the DPS of the Death Adder as it couldn't use it as often anymore. And with these two changes, the Death Adder is still a tier 1 pet to this day. If you put on a team, it's gonna do well, but it's not completely dominating like it used to. So this will probably be one of the few times in these videos where Blizzard nerfed the overpowered pet and it stayed a tier 1 pet instead of dropping to mediocre tier. Which should tell you how crazy it was if in its nerfed state, it's still one of the best pets in the game. Also, I should probably mention, there was also a bug for a while where the burrow ability Death Adders can take, but never do, didn't have a cooldown or something, which made them super OP for like a few days or weeks before it got fixed. The Death Adder was plenty overpowered as is, so I didn't really think it was necessary to bring that up. But for a short time, because of a bug, it was even more broken than he already was.